Hello people, hello! It's another episode of Route 247. We're gonna be learning some more stuff and getting on more journeys. Wow, look at this place. This is nice, isn't it? Oh, you guys should see that. This is amazing, it's epic. I feel like I'm in the clouds. First of all, I want to say a big thank you to everyone that's been sharing, liking, commenting and responding to the show, because you know, it means a lot to me. If you don't talk to me, then I won't be here. I'm just so emotional sometimes. Just, thank you so much. So what are we going to be talking about today? Today we're going to be talking about something that I learned on some social media. Some of you may have seen. If you haven't, you're going to learn today. We're going to talk about red flags and green flags. What is he talking about when he says red flag and green flag? Well, there's many things that a red flag and green flag could be, but I'm going to go to specifics from some inspiration that I got of some kind of social media which you've probably seen before. And if you haven't, you're going to learn today. So the first time I saw this clip, the first thing I thought to myself is, what? First of all, sometimes the way Jamaicans put things forward is the best way. There's no billy-dally, two-two explanation, and to make sure you understand what I'm going in. It's a red flag and a green flag. So there's two different episodes. The red flag is done by a woman, and she goes about talking about in when people get into relationships, things that you should look out for, which mean red flag.
Red flag. So me have so much pick me have. You know what six me have do. So how much different baby mother? You know a four different baby mother do.
Which mean no go. Then you've got the guy who's got a green flag. Now he's talking about the things that women do that men love and appreciate.
Green flag, green flag, green flag. You want a woman in your life when you're not work and you go through your struggle, she just did it for you and I share your backbone. She just help you when you're down and help you to get back up on your foot and she just did it for you. Green flag, green flag, green flag. You want that woman when she kisses and take away your breath to make you start have asthma. You want that woman when she come in your house and once she comes and this her scent alone make you float in the sky.
Upon watching this, I said to myself, boy, I think I've got some red flags and some green flags myself. I thought to myself, where am I back to at the moment? It's going to be the best time for me to get these kind of episodes out before, obviously, and then if I had a missus, some of the things I'm going to say, she ain't going to be happy with. So that's the reason I can do this and some of you lot can't do this. So some of the things I'm going to say, some of you lot ain't going to be here to talk about really or share, but luckily we're on Route 247. While you're on this journey, we can just explore a few things. So there's a red flag and there's a green flag. Now how you determine on these things depends on your standards. When I say standards, what I'm talking about is different things as to what you like and what you don't like. So everyone has their own. Some people's standards are really high, and some people's standards are medium, and some people have really low standards, and then there's some that have no standards.
Red flag.
So when we talk about flags, we're talking about standards, different ones. First of all, we're going to mention the green flag. Green flag is a good flag. A flag that everyone wants to be. So go, go, go. Everyone's going to be positive about. Then we're going to talk about the blue flag. Blue flag's a medium sort of flag. It's cool sometimes and sometimes it's not, but you know, it's a medium ground. Then we're gonna talk about the red flag. Now the red flag is a bad flag. It's the same thing as getting a red card when playing soccer. I ain't no amateur, I've been doing this for quite a while. You know, I've been doing promotions, club nights, DJing all about the place, Route 247, I mean, come on, I'm doing a lot. So I know through experience of working with people and going on things and doing stuff, that there's red flags and there's green flags. And in this game, you must know how to read them, and I'm going to show you some. Now, it's not like I wanna be out here all the time searching here and searching there. Two4's looking for love too, you know? Like, production company, you know? If we can make a show, like, you know, that flavor show when the girls come and I pick and they vote, you know? Yeah, huh? So this is for the production company, 247, looking for love. Like, we can have, like, bare girls coming down, like, follow on Instagram, Facebook, all the kind of things that could be all there battling for me. Like, it could be peak, it could be sick, though. Yeah, it'll be sick, I'm
freaking. Can we get back to the show, mate?
Oh, sorry. So right now, I'm going to explain why. Why I haven't found Mrs. Wright, or whatever it is you want to call it, or Mrs.
Green Flag.
Now see, I'm a gentleman. I never demand a green flag. I just kind of look for them. And I have little tips on how I look for them myself. Like I was saying, first dates. You've gone out for something to eat? Cheeky Nando's, we've all done it. You've had a nice little meal, nice little chat, it's been great. Now it comes time to pay the bill. This is where you're gonna see a clear indication of a green flag or a red flag. So when the bill comes down the table, obviously with man, we take it, we open it, we look at it. Now she offers to pay the bill.
Green flag, green flag, green flag.
From she offered to pay the bill, I guarantee she won't be paying the bill, but straight away still, on standards.
Green flag, green flag, green flag.
Or you're gonna want us like, boom, you know, whatever it is, like, what'd you say, 75? She starts taking out her 40 or whatever it is, she pays her half.
Green flag, green flag, green flag.
But then you've got those ones. When the bill comes, she wants to try and go toilet or start looking at Instagram and Snapchat on her phone. Do you know what that is?
Red flag.
And that's always the one that was talking lobster and she wanted the sparkling champagne. I'm like, what, we can't get a little Sauvignon Blanc? And lobster in Nando's? Even ladies, you don't need to know when you're looking out for a red and a green flag. I mean, I got sisters, I got daughters, I got lady female friends, I've got mums, aunties, it's peak. You don't need to understand something right now. So the date's gone well, you might have gone to another, wherever you've been, and the guy's now taking you home, he's dropping you home in the ride, and da 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 da. And I know you girls have all been for this, and you're thinking, uh-oh, here it comes, about to come to the house, and then he pops up outside, he's like, what, is that you? What, is that right if I come up for a little drink or a little something, he gets? You know what that means? Do you want to know what that means?
Red flag.
Why is it a red flag? Cause more time, you know, all man wants to do is
seems like you're ready. Seems like you're ready. Seems like you're ready. Girl, are you ready?
Red flag! But however, if the guy drops you off and says to you, do you know what, it's been a good evening, you've been a lovely day, I hope I can see you again, drops you nice, she lets you go and zooms off, and you're there thinking to yourself, you know what? That was a gentleman. You can call him back to the yard, it's cool, cause he's already got the
green flag, green flag.
So the date's finished, you live quite far away, but the guy said to you, do you know what, the cab just said, she looked on the app, boom, saw £44, he said to himself, nah, that's a bit harsh, boom, dropped her to the cab office and said, you know what, darling, hold a little 25 towards your journey. Blue flag, because he ain't trying to be anyone he ain't, he ain't trying to be the guy that's like, don't worry, got this, and at the same time, he ain't trying to be the guy that's like, boy, you're the one that chose to come down from Scarborough, boy, it's got nothing to do with me, boy. So now I want to talk about red and green flags underneath house inspection. So when we come into a house, all we want to see some basic stuff. Nice, clean, tidy, with some fresh air. For me, that's all we're looking for. I'm walking, I'm like, yes, this is inviting.
Green flag, green flag, green.
A few toiletries in the bathroom, I can see, right, she takes care of herself, everything's all in place and that. I'm like, ah, she's a clean one. But on the other hand, if she invites you around and she knew you was coming, and then you come round there and the place is looking like World War III, we got socks and pants hanging from the ceilings, we got clothes all over the shop, the carpet's being ripped up, when I sat down on the sofa there was a cover and I caved right in. Step into the toilet and there's no tissue paper. Teak brushes are all worn out, bent out. When I step up in the kitchen, and I'm seeing tampons in the bin.
Red flag.
Sometimes I live a fast life, so I bring something with me to heat up in the microwave. But when I open the microwave and inspect the microwave, and I can see bare bolognese and ketchup stains all pinging around in there. From how long ago? How long have these stains been there? Some of them are like, they're like rocking. I was trying to scrap. What the? So she invites you around for a cooked meal. She's done 3 courses. We've got prawn starters with garlic and butter sauce. We've got red meat. Red meat. On the table. With all the trimmings, the gravy, the greens, the mash, the mac and cheese.
Green flag, green flag, green.
We've got banoffee pie on the menu with Bailey's to go down with. Ah.
Green flag. Green flag.
A1, A1. That's A1, guys. That's A1. She probably watched the episode about the red meat. See? She's supporting. Cause this is A1. And those kind of ones there, that's proper green flag. Not any green flag. Not no breakdown company green flag. Proper fluorescent green flag. All in the nighttime, still glowing green flag. A1 green flag.
Green flag!
Did you see the bow? Did you see it? Did you see? Proper stuff. And then you got those other ones. So she's invited you around. It's not a three-course meal. It's a microwave meal. Really? So you said you're gonna invite me around, I'm gonna cook you food, and you've put on a microwave meal. That's an instant.
Red flag.
Box for a cup of tea. And this one thought it was a good idea to bring it to me in a plastic cup. A plastic cup! What? That's an instant. Now I'm gonna talk about the person that's had to go all out. She's gone shopping, she's got recipe books, she's gone in that kitchen and she's given it her best shot. But when she came out, when the plate came out and the food was there, I was cutting in thinking, you know what, this looks all right. Under closer inspection, the chicken seems to be a bit bloody or a bit red. The rice, still a bit hard. I swear they're still frozen. Now some of you be like, that's a red flag, that's a red flag. But me personally, I would say that's a blue flag. Because like, all right, she's probably got a good personality and a good heart, and she did try. You saw the recipe book on the side. She can't go, she's trying. But the fact that she's trying, she gets a blue flag. Blue flag is something that, you know, we can work on. There's room for improvement. Everyone can learn how to cook, but the fact that she tried, that deserves a blue flag. Now, when you score them with a blue flag is a very middle ground. It can be very close to very, very high up to the greens, or a tremendous dip down to the red. Are you gonna work your way up to a green, or are you gonna plummet down to a red? My thing is that you need to try, you know, if you think she's worth the game, put the effort in and try and make her that green, because there's not many left. Me, I've seen a lot in my time. I've seen people go from green flags, green, ticking boxes. Both sides, even from the back, the ticket in the front. It's still possible, it's possible for someone to have 50 greens and 4 major reds that make it a no-go zone. I'm sorry. And how do you make that transition?
Halfway.
From a green all the way to a red.
Take a few steps back.
Or even from a red all the way to a green. How is it even possible?
You ain't got the answers, man.
I've been sitting there night and night again thinking, how did it go from so far from one place to another? And my brain just said to me,
half. You ain't got the answers, man.
And he's right, I haven't got the answers. But when I do think about it, my thing is age. With age comes a lot of experience, and different numbers, different ages gives you different experiences in life. So this can mean many things, whether it's coming from a cultural, traditional background, or if you're coming from more of a modern background. Different things. So me, it all depends on age and what you was doing at that particular age. Cause there's a lot of people I know, some friends that I need to know, that were red flags. When we was coming up, we was red flags. But now, the red flag is no longer there. We're grown men. We're only greens. Guess what? Last week, I saw someone that used to be the greenest flag. Everyone wanted this green flag. A1 all the way. I'm telling you now, as the years have gone on, she's 100%
red flag.
How did that happen?
Red flag.
What is it that made her turn from a green flag to a red flag? And let me explain when I say age matters. When we're talking about where the flag exists, whether it's here, whether it's there, wherever it is, age is very, very, very important. For instance, there's different things that you're doing at a young age and you have way different standards at a young age. And that will be socially accepted at the time. So let's just say an 18-year-old, you can get away with quite a lot. I mean, you can get away with 3 different girls a week, a girl dating 3 different guys at a time, every weekend on the flirt, no problem. But now, as we fast forward on to maybe 30, 35s, even 40s, if you're still doing that, it's an instant.
Red flag.
When you're young, there's a lot of learning, and the only way you can learn is through mistakes. Really and truly, that's all you can do. So going through the years, if you're not learning your mistakes, if you're not learning and educating oneself, you will probably end up as a
red flag.
So the main thing here is to learn. Learn your craft. If you know yourself what is green and what is red, like I said, we've all got our own standards. We all have different standards to each other. You have yours, I have mine. If you know yours, make sure you're working your way to a green flag, because that's what you all want to be, right? So some people are asking, how do you keep yourself a green flag but still want to have fun? You still want to let your hair down? Come on, that's what we, don't we all? I mean, when you're young, you're allowed to do what you like. You can let off, it's fine. We're learning. We're finding ourselves. But as you get older, if he's not a boyfriend, I think it's best you keep your knickknacks on, keep them on. Still have your fun, but have your standards and your levels. And really, I'm only talking about age like 22, 23. Because once you start getting to them ages there, Judgment Day stamps time to come out. And the Judgment Day is going to start determining whether you're going to be a
red flag
or
green flag, green flag, green flag.
So let's start a little timeline. Got the young age here and the older age here. Now, if we use this time here, if you're still doing these things here, over here, it's not going to be a good look for ya. So basically, my thing is that you should keep all your dirt down here. All your learning, all your experiments, and all your sort of delving around and splashing about without your Wellingtons on or with them on, should stay around here. That's where you're learning stuff, and that's where all that stuff happens. But then as we get on here, here's the kind of part where we're having different boyfriends and different girlfriends, and we're learning, and we're sort of getting the sieve out and sieving out, knowing what we want to keep and what we want to throw away. But then as we get older, this is the time where you should know clearly what a red flag and a green flag is to you. And even when you're out and you're judging who's a red and who's a green, at the same time, you always got to look in the mirror and say to yourself, what are you? Are you a green flag? Or are you a red flag?
Green flag, red green flag.
Because you can't just be out there requesting flags, but at the same time, you're a clear red flag, but you're out there only looking for a green. That doesn't make any sense. That doesn't make any sense. And that's the problem with relationships these days. A lot of people are looking for something good, but that they ain't doing no good themselves. That doesn't make any sense. So you're out there and you're saying that you're looking for this and you want a man with that and he's got to have this and he's got to be doing this. But how close are you to that yourself? You're not really doing this. I don't see you doing that. Hold on a second now, check your survey. You ain't doing nothing. And then you got certain man that are just letting women just take care of them and look after them. She's going to work. She's got the car. She's doing everything for you and you're just sitting there? Nah. Certain things are red and green flags within themselves, whether you're in a relationship or not. Some people are just out there living that red flag life on a daily basis.
Red flag.
And some people are out there working their hardest, honest, and just living that green life.
Green flag, green flag, green flag, green flag.
As you can see, this one has been such a mind boggler for me, and I do need help from you guys. And hopefully we can get one of those dating shows, guys, if you wanna. Yeah?
We'll talk about it.
So make sure, let me know, guys. I want you to tell me. We need comments and feedback on this issue ASAP. What is a green flag to you and what is a red flag to you? Comment below or email us so we can do another episode on this very subject. As usual, we have the social medias. Use them correctly. Whichever one's the best one for you. Mention the show and what you want to talk about. Say your answer about red and green flags so we can talk about it next time. And until next time, guys, let's pull over here. Thanks for coming on the journey. I'll catch you for some more chit-chat on the next episode of Route 247.